Hello, my friends, and welcome back to our continued blind let's play, Yume and the Pulsating Mass. My name is the FlightlessBird, this is your Storybase Gaming Channel, and joining with us is the king of the giant robots, Zappa.
I'm here to guide you through all the shiny nooks and spooky crannies of this 8-year-old child.
It sounds like quite an adventure, so let's go ahead and continue, shall we? Okay, so rather than go to the town like we said we were going to do and do actual story stuff, I completely forgot about this room. And
so I think you need a break. So how about you have a nice sit?
Yeah, I agree. We need a nice sit. So let's go ahead and remember what button does what.
Tokyo!
Wow, everything just stopped. Everything just stopped. Oh, that works. Yeah, everything in the world just stopped. Dang it, Helga! So, is there some place where I need to stop time in order to get past? I know that's a dumb question. The answer is yes. Can you just tell me where it is so I don't have to go searching around for it?
Should I come out of the stopped time as well?
Yes.
Hey, so, there was a door. Every time you walked up to the door, the eyes were open and they saw you. And the door is closed.
Oh, that's the door I thought I need dash on.
Oh. Okay, it's on the other side.
On it. You see, that's what I was going to say. I was like, I would find this spot eventually. It's just, you know, you can save me about 10 minutes of walking around. It's oh so cool castle and a light bulb. So this was the door.
That was it.
See, you know what the interesting thing is? If you didn't tell me that, I probably wouldn't have known that that was the eye door. Because I probably would have forgotten about it. I just would have found an empty room with the chest. So thank you, Zappa. Appreciate that.
You're welcome. That's why I went quiet. It's like, how long until you ask me for help?
Well, it's something like that. That's not such a big deal. Because it's not like you told me the secret. I knew the secret. I just didn't know where the secret was. And yes, I did contact Zappa over the week and said, "Hey, Zappa, I totally forgot about that door. Remind me."
And I didn't have to.
No, you didn't. I still remembered. That like stuck out with me all week. Hello, if you look for Captain Fish, he's at the war dog with the rest of the crew. Me? Alright, look out to the sea war. Bars aren't really my thing. Alright, let's go to the war dog. How much money do I have? Zero money, because we put it all in the bank.
Yep.
Hey, Timmy's here. Hey Timmy. Jimmy? I'm Timmy. Anyway, people in the goddess said that Mute Notes was a dangerous place, but now that I'm here, it seems really cool. I think that people in the goddess might just be too stiff. Anyway, I hear that Ella's supposed to be on a really good show. Who's Ella? I don't know. Aren't you excited? Is this exciting? I hope my brother hasn't been too much of a handful. He's, eccentric, I know, but he's the only family I got.
Dang it. I was gonna do him, because he comes around a lot.
Alright, go ahead and do him then.
I hope my brother hasn't been too much of a handful. He's eccentric, I know, but he's the only family I've got. When I was away to sea too long, sometimes I even missed the guy.
And this is Mr. Marvelous. I suddenly give him the coins.
Jimmy! How many times are we going to run into each other? I'm starting to think you're the president of my fan club! Ho ho ho!
Boy, you're the president of my fan club.
I'm sure you've taken note of the distinguishing young frog sitting across me. None other than my younger brother, Henry. He's a marvelous sailor, you know. He was just regaling me with stories of his latest adventures, going from NXT to TNA. He was...
And back again.
I check in with him every now and again. He's my favorite sibling. One of 16,573!
Wow. Imagine the grocery bills. Sorry, that's a line from the Muppets Christmas Story. One of my favorite Christmas movies, by the way. We watch it every year.
Well, he's the only one that's still alive. The rest didn't make it out of the water. Goldfish, you know?
By the way, Sunfire, who's been commenting on the videos, actually agreed with one of my comments.
Can we switch back to regular Jimmy?
Sure. But he agreed with one of my comments when I... What the heck? Are we playing Amori all of a sudden? Is that Sunny? but anyway, thank you for commenting, by the way, on the videos. Much appreciated. But he basically said, yeah, he also thinks we're maybe in a dream or a coma. It makes sense with the world that we're given. But we'll have to wait and see what actually is going on. Jimmy can smell the stale remnants of cigarettes. What the heck is going on here? I'm going to talk to you last. Okay, now I feel like I'm playing Amori. This is the big boss man. The planet guy that we just fought.
Information guy, so easy to eat him, but now it's for acknowledge you.
I see. In damn lands? Treasure. Understand? I'm talking adventure, my boy. Name's Captain Fish. I'm the captain of the greatest ship to ever taste the sweetie sail to air of freedom. The Sea Worm. We're taking a break, mute notes, before heading back out for more adventure. Don't bother talking to my companion. Jorgen is a strange foreign land. I didn't talk much, but if he did, he probably wouldn't understand it. All the dots.
Wait, that was in his voice. It doesn't matter, all the dots.
What the heck is going on here?
I was getting ready for the gig. We'll be on in a minute. Keep it cool, kid. Keep it together, Yako. How many times have we played this old club? You'll be fine. Oh man, I bet I get sick on stage again. Jacko's kind of hopeless, but he's my best friend. The rhythm section has to stay together or the whole band falls apart. You know who they remind me of? In Final Fantasy X, there's a bunch of, like, playing instruments in the music pub.
Oh, yeah.
This place is normally pretty low-key, but all the weirdos show up when Ella sings. You better be on your best behavior. If I'm, you know, a real live knight. Or I was. I guess I'm just a bounce now. Wait, is he one of the, Legato knights?
He was.
Aren't you a little too young to be in a place like this? I can't serve you now. Wait, you're probably just here to listen to Ella's song. She's the best.
Oh! Did you hear that, Jimmy? Mr. Tanaka said we'll meet his friend here, so wouldn't it be fun to take in the show while we wait? It's been a while since we've gotten to unwind.
Character. I'm aside, kid. I've had a tough day. Oh,
one alcohol, Boozy. Make it a double. Come to listen to your sister? Huh. How come you don't go on stage anymore? We miss you, you know? Want me to sing to you, Boozy? I'll sing for you. Right to the bottom of this empty glass. Dale, Bobby Cakes. You gotta take me back. Me and a brass man. Did you see a dame trying to forget? Forget what? Forget me? Forget us? Fine. See how it is? You think you're smart. Like you know everything. Well, you sure know a lot about breaking a man's heart. Heh. I see an opening. What am I trying to level up? Bird.
Bird up.
But it's always good to start in this form for stealing purposes.
Okay.
I know to get work for the old grump now, so can't go drink away in troubles of peace. I can't go through the door anyway.
Nope, the door is not ajar. It's a door. That is a true statement.
Oh, I didn't realize. Nah, don't trust it, it's Nick guy. He talks too much. I want to punch those dim sunglasses off his face. He sets this up, I'm so ticked.
And John Bear's there too. Used to sing a little in college, you know. Oh, I'm sure I've told you a million times before. Helga and the Phantoms. I'd love to go on stage again someday.
Oh, there's another reference. Phantoms to our Ace Attorney game.
Oh, looks like the show's about to start. Wanna have a seat? Oh, there's still some time to have fun, but don't be late.
Jimmy, can't help but feel like you haven't been very talkative with me lately.
That's why I took the time to talk to you.
It is because you're sorry that you locked me in your closet. I just want you to know that it's no big deal. I mean, it was pretty lonely in there. And I think it's a pretty rotten thing to do your best friend, if I'm being honest. There were old clothes in there that smelled bad. It was dark. None of the other toys could talk. Yeah, overall, I say it wasn't pleasant. No, sir. But hey, I forgive you, buddy. That's what being friends is all about. And I'm a good friend. A very good friend. The best. And your best friend is just what's for a best friend for you.
Let's watch the show, shall we?
Yes. Order me an alcohol, Bird. Make it a double.
The wrong place. The right time. Your first steps. On landmines, huh? You drew me in a window that fogged up with your breath. I knew it never meant to last. Shaking as the car began to leave. I thought I found the only man who didn't look through me. I'm sorry that I'm fading with the moisture on the glass.
Sorry that I won't come back. Hello? Jimmy feels something brush up against his leg. What?
Nobody move!
When do we entertain and Rapa?
Inspector Ludwig here. If there's a case that needs solving, I'm the man to solve it. And right now, it looks like we got ourselves a case. The big one. And it starts with a capital M. Well, this ain't this just a mess. Looks like a mysterious sailor been put through the wringer. That's a euphemism.
No, duh.
No point in sugarcoating this. He's all tore up. He's been ripped apart.
And his legs look like spaghetti.
His guts is all over the place. Maybe I've been doing this gig for too long.
Maybe those aren't his legs. Maybe those are his guts, and part of it, and his legs are missing.
Gotten too cynical. But I'm mainly sorry for Boozy here. It's gonna take a hell of a deep tin before this carpet's not all gross. Not so fast, Toots. Where you going?
I'd sign up for that like this, Ludwig.
Yeah, well, neither did I, but I got a dead sailor in front of me and a hell of a mess to clean up. So you is staying right here. You're all staying right here. Wanna know why? You're all suspects. That's right, all of you, including you, Dame. I've got my eye on everyone here. That's the mayor. Watching you. Be a guy with a fishbowl for a hat?
I didn't even see that! I'm so blind! Yeah, he's got a giant goldfish bowl.
Watching you. That creepy quiet kid.
Which one?
You better believe I'm watching you.
Wait, where did Jorgen go?
Nobody's leaving this building till the murder's solved. End of story.
What do you mean, where did Jorgen go?
The other lookalike, me, he's not there next to Captain Fish.
But he's on screen.
Maybe he's blocking, maybe somewhere in the text box.
Oh, you can see him.
I don't see him anywhere.
But he's front and center.
Wait, is Jorgen the guy that got murked?
Yep.
Ooh. Eesh. I didn't see that.
Oh, man. The Jimmy lookalike got murked. Good thing Jimmy didn't look like Jimmy today.
Why not? Then can't a girl go and powder her nose?
Go ahead. I'm not going to stop you. But I'm not going to... I'm going to interview each and every one of you. And that means you too, Toots. So don't get any bright ideas while you're in there.
I'm just going to wash all this blood off my hands. Damn, maybe it's better not to go off by yourself. Oh, and I suppose you want to protect me. Some guard dog you'd be. I'll bark and no bite. Do yourself a favor, Spot, and find yourself a new chew toy. This one's all worn out. I need a drink.
All right. Now that all distractions is out of the way, it's time to get down to business.
To defeat the Huns. Sorry, just something I have to do whenever someone says get down to business.
Get ready to witness my exemplary powers of deduction. At work.
Wait!
Yeah, his, I just realized that that's his intestines. His whole body His old bottom half of his body is cut off.
Hello!
And I didn't realize his hair because I thought his hair was just like blood at first. No, that's his hair, and then his blood is beneath his hair. That is a gruesome sight.
Information guy here. Inspector Ludwig sure seems to have his hands full. Maybe you can give him some help. If you look around the room, you'll see several potential suspects. By talking to these suspects and using deductive reasoning, you can narrow them down. Then you can establish a motive. With a clear suspect and motive, you just might crack this case. Furthermore,
oh my god, they killed the information guy!
Oh. My. God. Someone knocked over this table! Probably the murderer. This is an important clue.
Speaking of clue?
Yep. Interview the suspects and find the motive. Or just talk to everybody.
Well, that certainly put a damper on the evening. Come to think of it, this club's quite froggy indeed. Seeing Henry was nice, but I'm very much looking forward to going somewhere marvelous.
As a lost crewmate, man. I don't know how the captain keeps it together. Well, I guess that's why he's the captain. I'll get Manny to help with the writing of the letter Jorgen's for. He's good with languages.
This kind of violence is totally inappropriate, Jimmy. Have you been watching scary movies with Buck again?
I don't like this, not one bit. They would kill those guys still here. Do you hear it running around in the dark? I don't want it too far away from me, alright?
You know, if we could just take a second though to talk about this song. The song almost sound like it was a car crash. And if Jimmy was involved, if real Jimmy, not this Jimmy, but if real life Jimmy, assuming that when a coma or a dream or something, maybe he was driving home, got in a car crash, and then that put him in a coma. And that's what we're living today. We're living him fighting for his life, trying to recover from his coma.
Everyone's upset. Just a little blood. Well, you can still have a good time if we use our imaginations.
Oh dear, Jimmy, something dangerous going on. I never felt so scared before. If I get attacked next, you'll protect me, right? Okay, so my long shot guess here, if, and I know this sounds like really weird, but if I'm just looking at who could be most improbable, keyword there, improbable, not probable, improbable. My dark horse is Jonathan.
Like the least likely to have done it?
No, like the most likely out of the least likely suspects.
Okay, so at the bottom of the list, he's at the top of the list of people that could have, couldn't have done it.
Yes, and you know, you don't expect your party members to be involved in this. You don't expect right. The Frogs to be involved in this, and you don't expect Timmy to be involved. So out of those six, I think Jonathan is the most likely. And of course I say out of those six because everyone else here we've never really met before. So it's very easy one of these other people could have easily done it.
We met Roland before. I mean, someone cosplaying Roland.
Yeah.
Poor Jurgen. Actually, I'm not too shook up about him. I lose crewmates all the time on the high seas. That's just part of Veach. Jurgen had only been with us for this short while. I remember he's a great guy, as a quiet guy who did his own thing. One time I asked him to pass me the butter and he stared at me for 5 solid minutes. Well, that was just the kind of guy he was. Well, he couldn't speak English as far as I could tell, so I don't hold him against him. Still, that cornbread was super dry and almost choked. The guy who made this game is from Texas, isn't he?
Kasey?
Yeah.
This first I heard about this. That's worth looking up.
Well, I could have swore I read something that said one guy from Texas made this game. So I'm not sure about that, but could have swore I read that somewhere. Because he says Texas. He doesn't say Japanese. So, I mean, he says English, not Japanese. So this makes me think this game was never originated in Japan.
Well, yeah, he's an indie dad.
If anyone comes out to LA, I'll clock him. So it's always been bad in this godforsaken town, but just got worse. What?
I just found his Twitter, and he's sure as heck from Texas.
Hey, how about that?
And he's in the middle of working on another game called Hymn to the Earless God.
Huh. I wonder if it's going to be in the same style.
It's far improved, because now he has a team.
Ooh. Well,
I'll throw my video of it at you.
Yeah, we'll have to pay attention to that. When this is all over, we got to find a new club in town. That's right, Ella. We're getting out of this one-horse town. You got to be the biggest star in the world. So he's the only one that really seems suspicious out of those people.
Clues all around you, kid. You just gotta know what to look for. Give me some time to work through this. I'll crack this case.
We can't talk to not Jimmy. Oh man, I'm such a failure as a bouncer. I was so into Ellis performance, I was completely off guard. I wish you would give me your autograph when it's all over. Booze is gonna freak out, that's just more alcohol for me. I get hammered. Don't say that, Yako, you're the best bassist I've ever played with. Everything will be alright, you'll see. My brother was right, I never should have left Legato. This is a travesty, my best days and years and this happens. Nobody's gonna want me to come here anymore. So the only one who said anything about Jorgen was Captain Fish.
Uh-huh. Everyone else is like, oh, there's Hamoida. But you've talked to everybody. I think you have to go to the restroom.
I did.
Oh, okay. Okay, there it goes. Moved on.
Everyone here? Good. Before I get into accusation, let's go over the clues I used to reach my conclusion. Clue number one. The bodies. They're all torn up. I mean, look at them. Blood is everywhere. Guts is missing. Even the bones have been gnawed on. It was the work of some new long frog with a derringer. This was done by a real root. Clue number two. The number of victims. Since there was a second killer, that must mean that the first victim wasn't the intended one. So, who was the intended victim? Knows. It was pitch black at the time of murder. As far as we know, the intended victim might still be Amogus. And clue number three. The Moiter has a flagrant disregard for tables.
That's a very important clue, actually.
Possibly hates all furniture. I'm not sure how this piece fits into the puzzle yet. Probably should have kept that one to myself, to be honest. Clue number four. This is the big one. This is the clue that's going to bust this case wide open. Are you ready for it? The light switch. Both murders took place in total darkness. Since there's only one light switch, the murder would have had to access to it prior to each killing.
I wasn't even paying attention to that when the murders happened, unfortunately.
As you all know, the first murder took place almost everyone in the room was listening to Ella's song. However, one person was absent. That person would have had access to the light switch. That person would have turned off the lights. Person would have ripped up the poor victim with his bare hands. And that poison is none other than you, Frank.
Yeah, it's definitely big enough. What?
Don't try to deny it, Frank. Everyone knows you're the local lowlife. A real thug. You stole cars. You picked pockets. You pushed kids around and stole some groceries from old ladies. This is just the next step in your life of crime.
It's true that I know a mess, but I didn't do no murders.
Kill it, Frank. You're going to wait for a long, long time.
What about this guy? I was nowhere near the light. Was this when he got killed?
I'm glad you asked. Here's what I think happened. At the time of the murder, Frank was waiting for his moment in the bathroom. At the end of Ella's song, he jumped out, turned off the lights, and proceeded to beat the first victim mercilessly. Then he ran back, turned on the lights, and sucked into the bathroom to clean up amidst the confusion. After washing away the evidence, he returned and took a seat at the bar where he was during the second murder. As you all know, the second murder happened very quickly. It would have been impossible for Frank to run across the room, turn off the lights, murder the second victim, and run back without us noticing. As it so happened, the second person left the room prior to the second murder. Remember? I do. There is none other than your accomplice, Miss Dale.
Da 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 da. Not Dale. My sister would never fly.
That may be true, Miss Ella, but she would let your boy Toy do the killing for her. My suggestion is that Miss Dale turn off the light while Frank was quickly dispatched the second victim. Now all we have to do is arrest both murderers. Big Eep. Miss Dale. Probably just some kind of distraction tactic. Everyone pile into the women's restroom. It's official police business, so it's not weird.
You heard the detective. Let's see what the hubbub's about.
Let's go. Moving in this room is kind of weird because you can't move between certain areas.
Right. The collision of objects is weird in this room. Very inconvenient.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Pack. Pretty cramped in here, yeah. Are you alright? I didn't get you anywhere, did I? Dale, I'm here for you, baby cakes. I ran by so fast, I think it crawled into the air ducts. I'll get into some thought. This is probably the second worst game I've ever played. What was the first?
I've never been in here before. Another exciting event here.
This country is crazy, man. I wonder what crazy place we'll wind up in next. The captain and the knack for finding their worst places.
I've got a particularly marvelous statue that would really bring this room together!
Keep an eye out, Jimmy. Don't forget that the murder is on the loose. That's why I'm sitting here with everyone.
Now I have to replace the vents. I feel a little uncomfortable in here. That guy with beefy arms of murder, I'm going to start way up, I'm going to stay way over here. It smells worse than I thought it would in here.
That grate's been torn wide open. Hey! Kid! Boozy tells me this end up goes to the utility closet. Mind following me? If someone's in there, I might not be able to take him alone. Huh? Why am I asking a kid? Well, you're not from around here. If I'm wrong about the whole Moira thing, I'm gonna really look like an idiot. If I tried to throw under the bus, no one would believe an outsider like you. So, you don't get to become a private eye unless you got smarts like me.
Is this our next dungeon, possibly? Nope, I can't get up there.
Nope. Ah! Don't sneak up behind me, kid. Got a bad news.
I got some bad news.
The closet door was open when I got here. Let's check it out. Oh dear.
Now, I'm not gonna say it looks like me because we did take their disguise, but at the same time, that looks like me.
This must be Mr. Tanaka's friend. Don't worry, Jimmy. We may not have a lead, but I'm sure we'll be able to find Uncle Lars and your father. Looks like we got another Moira on our hands. Moira must have come down in this room, so everyone in the bathroom is innocent. Including Frank. Oh, he's gonna be so mad. Probably gonna get peed up pretty bad. Yes, I deserve it. Look, kid, you're free to go, but don't tell anyone about this yet. Means that the murder is out there on the street somewhere. So if you're leaving, careful.
And I don't know why Murder Bear sounds like a possibility.
And drop a save. Do a save. Do a save, yeah. Make sure you're all stocked up.
We are.
Excellent.
Oh, it's the dog!
Well, well. Woof. Been a long time, Jimmy.
The dog and the wharf dog. Makes sense.
When you escaped, I knew it was only a matter of time before I found you again. I just had to sever my ties with those useless dogs. Woof. Now I have you all to myself. Do you like the presents I left you? I wanted very much to give you your own organs.
Yes.
Oof. Too bad there were so many people in them. No bother. There will be no escape tonight.
Oh my god. What the? As one evil mutt. Thing is so... Oh my god. I don't think it's undead.
Nope.
Make sure I go first to shut him down. Music is so good in this game, by the way. I love this music. Miasma.
Welcome to Group Poison.
Oh, that sucks. It even worked on our mom.
Group Poison.
That did not work. Yeah, I can't cure that. But I can heal it, so it's okay. It's not a big deal, it's just a consistent debuff. But that's okay. That's the worst it can do. It's not so bad. Okay, that's not the worst thing to do. It's still okay.
Frenzy is just the worst one. If you're sufficiently leveled, Miasma is more of an inconvenience. What weapon did you give Jonathan?
I'm not sure.
Or does he have the group hug on?
Nice. Oh my god. That is not nice.
Recover, Maul.
Okay, single target attack. I'll take that.
Wait, it did mean something. Okay, nope, Jimmy is scared this turn.
Yeah, I saw.
I thought it was like, oh, he did it late. So it didn't matter.
John, that was a crit. Jimmy is so paralyzed. Almost there.
The organs have kicked in.
Booyah! Take that mug.
Booyakasha! Jimmy done his best.
John, there's Alamo 18.
That's it. They're gone. He's gone. It's over. The city is solved. Although I think you have to, like, come and go before things make progress. I mean, before people reset to where they should be.
Henry's about to set sail again! I know that you enjoy our chat, Jimmy, but maybe you should send him off!
When did that last we'll see of him?
He gets awfully lonely out there without me!
Or if the dog is gonna return. I feel like it's experience while I was close together as a band. There's a big world out there, kid. As big as you can imagine. I'm sure we'll run into each other again. You know, it might not be as tall as my brother, but when my friends have my back, I feel like I just go about anywhere. Dale is so much more tender to Earth than me. I'm going to miss her so much. Oh, it was always a talented one. I hope she writes me since I'll be stuck here. So about so I am. He's going to find me for sure. Yeah, that's right. I used to be a member of the Legato Knights. I was actually good at that job, too. What's that? When's this getting nice back together? Heck yeah, I'm interested. Being in Legato was the best days of my life. Well, I mean, that was the... You know, that was the whole thing with the queen and all, but I'm pretty sure she forgive me for having to restrain her. You know, if she hadn't gone crazy and all that. Anyway, if Winter wants me back, then I'm going back.
Whoop, and he's gone.
One down, three to go. Everyone pitch in, I'll clean the up place. I hope this whole triple homicide thing won't hurt the business. Ha ha ha.
He's cleaned up.
Probably gonna have to travel pretty far to find a more hoppy club than this. Being a musician can get pretty stressful sometimes. Don't try to hold me back. I'm gonna murder this guy. I'll teach him to call me a murderer.
Things were said. Stakes were made. And one more thing. Admit that. Just go easy on the face.
Alright, you guys
and
have fun.
And one more thing.
Well, that is not the last and the end of Inspector Ludwig.
Inspector finally let us go. Apparently, the murder was just kind of a wild animal.
Hey, I was right about Jonathan being an animal.
Poor Jorgen.
Henry explained everything to me. So we got all this great science, if was, the better. It is Jimmy Company. I heard you were looking for a couple of family members. I just happened to be down one able-bodied sailor. What do you say, Jim, my boy? Want to sit down and venture the high seas? My excellent man, you're for a treat. What's that? Where are we going? Who knows? We know where we're going, some adventure that would be.
Mine's in One Piece. Without a compass to be our guide, we just sail the high seas.
Looking for the Grand Line.
You know they're gonna find out, right?
What? Find out what? Jonathan? That was weird. Oh, music slaps. Oh, Jimmy, you're probably up. Something went wrong with the covers, so we found a strange land. Guess we're probably going to be in a strange land in the first place. This land seems particularly strange. Probably gonna be staying for a while, so you might as well go exploring. Don't worry about us, we're used to traveling on our own. The heck? Where is this place?
We're finally out here for a minute before the captain got eaten by this strange plant. He just opened up his mouth to the captain and bet me he could fit his whole head inside. Don't worry about him. I'm sure he'd be fine. It's the first time he's not been eaten by a monster.
Everything's all like death and gloomy vibes. Hello, Leviathan.
Yes.
Oh, you missed out on a verb. A verb opportunity.
Okay, I'll go back.
New foe, who dis?
Music is new too.
The big cheese. Time to get that furniture.
I'll try stealing from two different targets. I only need one, but...
Right.
Ooh!
Fire. How do you like that those special effects, those fire effects?
Fire effects are awesome, but dang, that did a lot of damage. Wow, that music is so intense. And I haven't seen a fountain yet, have you?
You'll find one. But no, there hasn't been a fountain yet. You just got here.
Oh, I forgot Ooh. To change the bird. Well, I'm trying to steal, so.
What could you possibly verb on this screen? Well, let's go over your verbs. We have dash. That's not helping. That didn't do anything. Five, six, seven.
So, what am I missing?
Well, what is his verb?
What? Oh, I didn't think about grabbing the skull.
You push and pull.
I didn't think about that.
But what are those wispy looking things right there? What are those? What could that be?
I don't know. Am I doing something wrong?
No, you're doing it right. I'm just trying to be vague.
I feel like I'm playing Final Fantasy X and I'm in Cloister Trials. I'm at 12, nice. Off. How goes now 19?
Hmm? I will tell you, you're missing a verb.
So I don't know this, I'm missing a verb anyway.
But do you see what might need to be happening?
I need to block both of them. I didn't even know there was a second one there. That was the problem.
I didn't know where it was. I just knew it existed.
Hello.
Oh, grip, steal, crime.
No,
spin the wheel, bird.
Well, left is always right.
Spin the wheel.
Is this better? How whimsical. What the heck? No. The heck was that all about?
That's the entire gimmick of that whole fight.
Is that like one of those ghost dog guys?
No, you literally stole the wrong one.
Okay, so I blocked both those off, but I don't think anything's happening.
Because you don't have the final bird. You don't have the... So, you steal, and you just one of those four is the correct one.
Hey! Oh. Well, you know me, I'm not very lucky.
You'll get it sometime.
Jimmy misses home. I got a feeling I know how that verb.
Right. I think if we go up through the middle, we can get to that verb sooner. And then finish exploring.
Well, normally I always go up last when I play a game like this. Because that's usually progress.
But we want progress this time. And then explore. Remember, nothing is missing. Welcome to the Village of Scriffs.
This plant can't be eat. Can't eat you. Be careful. The other day, I fished weird statue from ocean. It really grimy, covered in barnacles. I not complaining. Scriff loves garbage. Problem is, after I put in house, it start whispering to me in nightmares. Run perfectly good nightmare. Always up and rally around too. So annoying. I throw out, but hard to get rid of perfectly good garbage. You understand.
Ah.
Jimmy feels like someone's watching him. The heck?
Rotting Jack-O-Lantern. He's very undead.
Yeah, I figured that one. Problem is, most of my damage is physical.
Yeah, you could switch to... I was about to say, switch to Flower. Upped his magic power.
That's fine.
Okay. Hmm. That's why it was fine?
Uh-huh.
Sometimes it's nice to have just a straight up boss fight that doesn't have silly gimmicks.
That one hurt.
Told you.
I really want a level bird, but right now I need flower.
Okay.
Because that's really my only damage. Jimmy not level 19? Buck's not level 19.
Do the voice, Bird.
Jimmy imagines himself floating above his own grave. Oh dear. It wasn't supposed to be like this. He holds up his hands and can see right through them. He thinks he should be bummed out, but, well, he's floating. And that's pretty cool. He hovers forward using his mind. Yeah, this is awesome. A somber man wearing church clothes is walking towards him. Jimmy asks for directions, but the man just walks right through him. Hey, Jimmy yells, but the man doesn't turn. Jimmy gets so mad, he swats the back of the man's head as hard as he can. The man turns around, confused, but doesn't see Jimmy. When the man starts walking again, Jimmy thinks it would be pretty fun to pull the man's pants down. So he does. The man's pants shoot down to his ankles mid-step, and the man falls right on his face. Oh man, that was even funnier than Jimmy imagined. He cackles and flies through the night, knocking off people's hats, opening and closing doors at random, and grabbing keys when people set them down and moving them places they won't look. This has all been hilarious, but he's feeling a little tired. So he floats home, thinking of all the fun pranks he could play on Buck. When he gets there, it's so late that all of the lights are out. The only one that's still on is in the living room. Buck is probably staying up late watching horror movies. Jimmy thinks that maybe he can make the TV change channels and freak him out. When he gets there, though, the TV isn't even on. It's just his mom. She's shuffling through a box filled with Jimmy's old stuff. There's his favorite shirt. There's the baseball cap he's been wearing recently. And there's a picture of his family he colored in class. His mom finger traces along the board of a framed picture of Jimmy when he was just a baby. Her eyes are red and raw. Fat, wet tears blink on the glass. Jimmy floats up to his empty room. He doesn't feel like playing pranks anymore. More evidence that there's something really, really wrong with us.
Jimmy just empathizes with the ghost, that's all.
Jimmy can now turn into Ryan Jack-O-Lantern. As a Ryan Jack-O-Lantern, Jimmy can ignite, oh, a small fireball. So that's how you get rid of the vines. This can burn some things and illuminate dark places. Oh, like that one does. Thank you for watching this video. Feel free to comment on what you saw and what you'd like to see next. I always love to hear your thoughts. But before we go, please remember that you matter and you are brilliant and you are loved and you should always be true to yourself. Never let the world tell you any different. Much love to you from your friendly, feathered, flightless bird.